This is an overview of Blackboard 9.1 for students. At the end of this video presentation, you will be able to recognize the updated appearance of our learning management system with the assistance of this video and locate some of the features available to you in Blackboard. UOIT.blackboard.com is where you will log in to the learning management system. You will use your banner ID and password to log in. You will notice that the entry page of Blackboard has an updated appearance. This page is called the My Institution page, and it includes modules containing information about your courses and UOIT announcements. When you log into Blackboard, take a moment to familiarize yourself with the modules on your My Institution page. You can personalize the appearance of your My Institution page by clicking Personalize Page. You can access your courses from the Course module. In most of your courses, the home page will be a module page similar to the My Institution page. The difference is that the modules in the course homepage include information relevant only to the course you are in. To the left of the course page is your course menu. Similar to the course tools section of WebCT, the course menu will help you navigate your courses. You can choose to look at your menu in list view, folder view, or in a new window. Depending on how your instructors have designed their courses, the course menu could look different from course to course. There is a help link on your course menu. Clicking here opens up a Blackboard site. An important section of the course menu is tools. Let's take a look at what a tools area might look like. Some of the course tools that appear here might not be available to you in all of your courses. There may be links to various tools within your course menu, but all the tools you have access to in a given course will be available in the Tools area. You can access the My Grades tool from the Course Tools area. A link to this tool might appear in your course menu as My Grades or simply Grades. Note that you can also access course messages here. There is no notification icon for new messages, and Blackboard messages won't be sent to your personal or school email address, so be sure to check in here regularly. In WebCT, you were used to seeing a course content area which was accessed in your course tools menu. Now your instructors have the option to add several content areas of various names which are accessed from the course menu. This is an example of a content area. Blackboard users can now add mashups, such as YouTube videos, SlideShare presentations, and Flickr photos. Experiencing a form of media through another is considered a mashup. Using the text editor in assignments, journals, wikis, blogs, discussions, etc., you too can add multimedia. Let's take a look at the text editor feature by opening an assignment. Note that your instructor might have an assignments page with a link on the course menu, or assignments might be included within a content area as they are in this example. This icon allows you to add a mashup. Be sure to cite these materials correctly. You can copy and paste work from other word processing programs. You can also attach files if your instructor has enabled that option. It is important that you click Submit when complete. That applies to tests as well. You also have the option to save as a draft if your work is not ready to be submitted. When you click Save as Draft, this is what you will see. The Review Submission History page. You can click OK to go back to the content area or click to continue current submission. When you click Submit, the Review Submission History page appears. You can click OK to return to the content area where you access the assignment. This Start New Submission option means that your instructor allowed more than one attempt. Let's take a look at a discussion board. You might see a link to the discussion board on the course menu. Otherwise, you can access it in the Tools area Discussion boards can also be located within groups if your instructor has enabled group discussion boards. To respond to a forum topic, click the title and select Create Thread. Be sure to click Submit when complete. This concludes your introductory overview of Blackboard 9.1. For more information, please access the resources posted by the Teaching and Learning Center and visit the Blackboard On Demand Learning Center.